Now, let's just talk just a little bit more in the second half about playing shapes. I mean, you have some more that you would do if you were to prepare this for a performance in terms of the slow practice, finding the perfect pitches every time and the best tone every time. But I think it's there's a danger of spending too much time getting it just perfect and then thinking that later you're going to come back and make it musically interesting. To put back in the musicality too late in the game means that you have to rethink a lot of your shifts and your bow distribution, etc. So shape-wise, how a jig, how can we inspire people to think of this as a dance movement? And if anything, you're going to get them to tap their toe or move in their seat. Would love to see the audience responding somehow physically when we play this. So the bow will have a certain energy and verve and crispness and flair with all of the attacks and the releases. And you can even, when you play it under tempo, you can play it as though it's a very fast performance that we're watching in slightly slower motion, slowed down, right? Bop, bop, be, up, bop, by, up, bop. Try it from the second half. Good, good. Now, look at the curves I'm trying to draw. You know, straight lines are anathema to music in general, I would say, but including string playing. So I'm playing scoop. I'm exaggerating. Dum bum be ya dum be ya da da dum bum bum. See, to me that already sounds much more natural in every sense of the world, every sense of the word. So try it one more time and think of even more of the weight out here at the tip. Good. Second phrase. Good. Now that third phrase, the pickup to 17, seems safe. And I think another thing that is anathema to musicianship is safety. You know, people hearing something that's played safely is inside the norm of their experiences, and that's not too likely to leave them with an impression or move them. So here we have a sequence like we have in many places. The first one. Now at a higher pitch level, usually a little bit more insistent. Now at a higher pitch level still. So ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum. If anything, I think that should be a very, very extravagant, indulgent. That should be a pouring forth. Would you take the pickup to 17 and play out? Yeah. Good. And if you recorded yourself and you decided, oh, that's over the top, that's too much, again, I think it's very easy to back it down, much more easy than it is to, especially on stage, decide, now I'm going to play it more musically than I ever have before. Probably not likely. Either that or it's going to cause technical problems. But if you play it very musically in the practice room, then to shrink it down is
easier.
Yeah, much more so. Great. Very good work.